Hello, kind sir.
Oh, hello.
Do you like secret door transitions?
Well, yeah, of course.
Do you want to have the ability to make a secret door transition from whatever you like to wherever you like?
Well, not exactly, but...
Well, do I have a sale for you? Dylan Secret Door Transition Emporium is the leading seller in secret door transitions. We have transitions into old doors, colorful doors, and disappointing ending of Game of Thrones doors. Come on down and give us a knock to get yours today.
Gee, mister, no fooling?
Of course I'm fooling, cliche 1920s commercial ad me. But I can teach you how to create one so it looks like Brandon Lee or Benn TK. Let's jump into it. Okay, so here's what ours will look like in the end. A little cheesy? Yeah. Have I ever used this in a project with a client? No, but that's not to say I wouldn't. If created well and used properly, it can be cool. It can be a cool little transition into another clip. So with choosing your shots, you first want a clip of you pushing into what you could imagine being a small little entrance to another world. Get creative here, but remember the more intricate the shape of the imaginary door, the more painstaking the masking process is going to be. One of the only requirements for the second shot is that you keep it as steady as the first shot and moving in the same direction as the first shot. This will help it appear like the camera is moving through the door of the entrance. So step one, retime your clip so it's not going through the door super slow unless you want that. Just know you'll have to mask really well because it will give the viewer more time to see imperfections. After this is done, copy your clip and place one beneath. This bottom clip will be the moving door that opens to the other side. Step two, mask the outline of the entrance on the first shot. Make sure you invert the top shot, have original on and keyframes pressed so you can see the original shot and your adjustments are saved. Then move frame by frame, matching up the mask to the edges you've chosen. This will take a while, I'm warning you. The more you tweak it so the mask isn't jittery, the better it'll look. Step 3, mask the outline of the outer perimeter of the moving entrance. Once again, click original and the keyframes so you can see the original outline and save your adjustments. Then continue masking like you did with the first shot. Step 4, play with the feather and fall off in both clips masking effect window to get the desired edge you'd like on both. Step 5, put both clips on composite. Then use the transform tool and making sure to press the keyframe button so your adjustments are saved. Drag the moving door as the shot progresses so it appears to open slowly and fluidly. This will take a little time to make it look natural. Step 5, import your other side destination clip and using the transform tool and after pressing the keyframe button, make it a little smaller and gradually make it bigger as the shot continues. You may need to speed up the sizing when your door clip increases in speed. Remember, match the speed and the direction of the door clip with the destination clip as well as possible. Step 6, add some overlays like these to achieve a desired effect. I got these from videvo.com, I'll post the link below. Make sure to click screen when you overlay them. Also, you can add a zoom effect so the movement into the next shot feels more natural. Make sure to add the zoom effect to an adjustment layer so it impacts everything on the timeline. Last but not least, add some nice matching sound effects and you're done. You just created your very own secret door entrance transition and you didn't even have to go to my emporium. Get creative when making this. Use picture frames, clocks, or really whatever you can find. Now get out there and go practice. But first, give this video a thumbs up if you liked it and shoot me a comment below. It helps me out a lot with progressing this channel. And don't forget to subscribe. See you guys on Saturday.